Y feliz domingo por la mañana, Pastors Jose and Patricia, we welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend, amen. Yeah. Bienvenidos a la iglesia de Nuevo Comienzo. Hallelujah, welcome all our NBC family, all our visitors, all those of you joining us by audio or video. Welcome, 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 amen. So praise God, we won't hold you long. We just want you to be excited. We want you to know that God has something for you, amen. He's got a blessing for you, so you got to receive it, amen. Hallelujah. Let the word of God bless you, encourage you, change you, and correct you. Praise God. We're going to be talking about one of my favorite subjects. We're going to be talking about making yourself available or being available to Him. Amen. We've been talking about, let me see, I'm really here, staying focused in Him, staying joyful in Him, and God wants to use you. Well, you know what? God can't use you if you're not available.
That's it.
So you have to make yourself available. Amen. And also know that God is not finished with you. God has a plan for you. And He wants to use you. Amen. So regardless of what the world has told you, regardless of what people has told you, or so-and-so, you know, they're real popular for that. To tell you, you know, God can't use you anymore. You know, what you've done or what you've been through. No. He wants to use you. Amen. He's not finished with you. Just make yourself available to Him. Amen. And know that you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, amen. Greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. I'm a winner, I'm a champion, and I'm an overcomer. Tell yourself these things, amen. Confess these things to yourself.
Amen.
And you know, if you're by yourself, say them out loud so you can hear them yourself.
Yeah.
So praise God. Amen. Before we get too far ahead, grab your sword, soldier of God, warrior of God, grab your sword, and let's make this declaration together, amen.
Amen.
Okay, here we go. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be taught the word of God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'm not going to be assigned in Jesus' name. Amen. Just a quickie. You know, the battlefield is the mind.
Yes, it is.
And that's where the enemy attacks the most. That's where the media attacks the most. And if you don't renew your mind with the word of God, you're just going to fall. You're going to fail. You got to stay full of the word.
Amen.
Confess the word over yourself and renew your mind with the word of God so you don't fall. I'm going to continue to do and be and fulfill what God has called me to do by staying full of the word. So I don't fall. So I don't go backwards. Amen. I want to go forward. Amen. So be available to God. Amen. And here's the thing is, serve Him passionately. Amen. Whatever you've done before, whatever you like, I love sports. I was passionate about sports. And I knew everything about sports. You could ask me, I was a sports encyclopedia. Man, I was passionate about it. Well, now I've turned that around. I want to be passionate for the things of God. Amen. And be like Him. Jesus, my greatest example. See, I'm going to be an imitator of Him. Imitate Him.
Yeah.
And not the world. Amen.
Yes,
let's go. We got a couple of scriptures. I want you to write these down. Amen. And go and check them out later on. You know, we teach the word. And we teach from the word. And we have scriptures. And our text, one of our texts is found in Isaiah 6 and 8. So let's go to Isaiah 6 and 8. Here we go. Be available to Him. Praise God. Isaiah 6 and 8. Isaiah is saying this. And you can say the same thing. Let's read it together. 6 and 8 says what? Also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, you know, you got to stay focused to hear the voice of God. There's so many voices out there want your attention. There's so many distractions. But you have to stay focused on Him.
Yeah.
He said, he heard the voice of the Lord saying, who shall I send and who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I. Send me.
Yes.
Amen. Have you ever said that to the Lord?
Oh,
amen. We've heard so many negative confessions from the world about yourself that we just are no longer available for God because we're believing what they're saying. Well, let's believe what the Word of God says. Isaiah says, here am I. Send me, Lord. Why not me? You know, He's not looking for abilities, he's looking for availabilities.
Yeah.
Amen. I have a lot of good things to share with you. So write them down, amen. Write them down. So that's one of our texts right there. Here am I, send me. Another one is smart found in Mark. Let's go to Mark chapter 1, verses 17 and 18.
Mark 1.
Jesus called his disciples. Might start at verse 16 with this. And now Jesus, as he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, and they were fishers. And Jesus said unto them, come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men. And straight away they forsook their nets and followed him. Amen. So this is a couple of texts that we have here. They immediately followed him. Amen. Well, Jesus has called us. And he's trying to call us. And he's calling us all the time. But we are not focused on him.
Right.
I think I told you last week. Jesus sent you a friend request. Have you accepted it? He wants you to accept it. And when you accept it, you make yourself available for him to use you.
Yeah.
Amen. But we told the brothers, you know, I'll make you fishers of men. Immediately they left what they was doing and come and served him. And they made themselves available. Well, I can't leave my work. I can't leave my job. I can't do those things. Come on now, I'm talking to somebody. You know, because we don't want to leave our careers. We don't want to leave what we're doing to follow him. We don't want to make any changes. And then everybody else can change, but I'm not going to change. But these men are professional fishermen. They know what they're doing. And they don't want to give up their jobs. They don't want to give up their careers to follow Jesus. I mean, we don't know anything about this man. Who is this man? But you know what? It's time to make a change. It's time for you to make yourself available.
Amen.
Amen. So praise God. Woo! Hallelujah. And it says, Jesus said unto them, when it says them, scratch that and put your name there. Mm-hmm. I put my name there. Make it personal. Write, personalize your Bible. Mark it, highlight it, underline it, whatever, but put your name on there because he's called you. Man, I'm going to read you some things. I'm getting way ahead of myself, but that's okay. Jesus says, I want you to be available. I want you to be passionate when it comes to loving me, when it comes to serving me, and when it comes to living for me. Be available and be passionate. People are available and passionate about everything else and anything else except God. Amen. Come on. We have excuses for not serving him. Amen. Why? I don't want to go to church. No, I don't want to go there. I know I don't want to do that. Come on. We're passionate about, you know, politics, news media, sports, partying, movies, fashion, foods, cooking, and whatever is your favorite. If I don't mention it, just put your favorite in there. But we're not available or passionate about God. That's a no-no. Amen. Remember, we've talked about this. Part-time Christians are no match to a full-time devil. And it's a battle. A spiritual battle that you cannot win without the word of God. It's a spiritual battle that you cannot win without him. I have a bumper sticker on my truck that says, hey, it's hell without Jesus. Even in Israel, it's hell without Jesus. Amen. Praise God. Be available, be passionate for him daily.
Yeah.
Not just once a year or twice a year, but daily be available to him. Have a winning attitude. Never double. Soaring high. And not scratching. Setting your right priorities daily. Seeking him first. Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. Listen to this. No more excuses.
That's it.
And if you find another one, don't take it. Or don't pick it up. Don't you think he's already heard all the excuses? Some of you are supervisors. And you have people work for you. And I'm sure you've heard all kinds of excuses why people don't show up. Come on now.
Oh, yeah.
And God has heard them all.
Oh,
no more excuses. Amen. If you find one, don't pick it up. God is not looking for perfect people. Listen, he's not looking for perfect people. He's looking for available people.
Amen.
Who are available to and passionate to serve him.
Yes.
Amen. This I was going to read to you this. I have some good ones up there too. Go ahead and switch that one, Carmen. Here we go. Jesus was available. Are you?
Mm-hmm.
Jesus made himself available. He had a choice. You know, one day in heaven, when the Father called Jesus, said, come here, son, I want to talk to you. And he sent him on his mission to come so he could be sacrificed so he can gain his people back.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus made himself available. He says, Father, I'll go. Jesus made himself available when he was born of the Virgin Mary. He made himself available every day.
Yes.
He could have just said, no, I've had enough. But he made himself available. What about you? Jesus made himself available. What about you? He's our greatest example. Amen. Let me read this to you. It says, God isn't looking for abilities,
that's right,
but rather availability. Amen. God doesn't call the qualified.
Mm-hmm.
God qualifies the call.
That's it.
Amen. All of us are called, but some of us are not answering. It's time we answer the call. And I wrote this down below that. It says, you're called, you're qualified, you're anointed, and you're totally equipped to make yourself available. You are totally equipped to win and fulfill and complete your race.
Amen.
Amen. Totally. But you know, it's time you step out of your closet. It's time you step out of your boat. Amen.
Yeah.
We need to step out in faith on a daily basis. You know, when you get in the Word, you study the Word, you're building your faith. And you're no longer in fear. So, fear's got to go. Where there's faith, fear goes. So you want to get rid of your fears? Get full of the Word of God.
Amen.
Amen? And fear has to go. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil. He'll flee from you. Amen? Come on now. God preaching better than the amen to me now.
You are.
Amen. God is not looking for perfect people, but he's looking for available people that are passionate for him.
Yes.
Keep going. I've got a few of these that are good. Can I be used by God? I know. I hear you talking.
Yeah.
I hear you. He hears you too.
Mm-hmm.
Says, when are you going to make yourself available?
Yeah.
He's sending you the friend request.
Mm.
And you keep delete it every time.
Mm.
He's calling you because you're listening to the world. You're listening to negative reports. Whose report are you going to believe? Are you going to believe his report and what the Bible says? Or are you going to continue to believe what negative people say? Are you going to believe what the world is saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's time you start listening to what he has to say about you.
That's it.
Amen. The crowd is going the wrong way.
Yeah.
The hill. Sometimes
mm-hmm.
that crowd is going the wrong way.
Yeah.
We got to stay on the right way. We got to stay focused on the things of God.
Yes.
Keep going. Man, these are good.
Yeah.
People may give up on you, but God never will.
That's it. That's so true.
I told you when I was praying and asking God, you know, take these enemies away from me.
Mm.
I lost a lot of friends. So guess what? Some of their friends have to go.
Yeah.
And if they go, we're going to get them back.
That's it.
Amen. Let them go. God's going to bring you the right people.
That's it.
And there's some people in there that are there for a short time, some for a medium time, and some for a long time.
Yeah.
But he knows what people to put around you. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Keep going, Carmen.
This
is good. God does not ask about our abilities or our inabilities,
mm-hmm.
but our availabilities.
Yes.
Amen. You know, all the abilities he's given you, he's given you the gifts and the talents, all those things he's given and put in you. But you know what? You can use them as you serve him,
yes.
as you make yourself available and serve him.
Yes.
Amen. Whew, come on.
Yeah.
Keep going. Available. Are you available to be used of God, by God? Are you a trophy or are you a tool?
Right.
You know, tools get used.
Mm-hmm.
Servants get used. But trophies, man, they just get put up. And you never see them again. And just for seeing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, make excuses.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not a trophy. I'm a tool that God
yeah.
can use.
Yeah.
He says, one, he's the head, we're the body. Many parts in this body.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the tools that we are, amen? And we can do what God has called us to do. Let me read this to you. Available. What is available? Available is to be obtainable, to be accessible, to be existing. Here's another thing is, available is to be unfilled. What is going to fill you? How are you going to get filled? Are you going to get filled with the world? Or are you going to get filled with the Word? Are you going to be for God or against God? I want to be filled, but if I want to get filled, I want to get filled with the right things.
Yes.
Amen. I want to get filled with Him. So praise God. Passion. What is passion? Getting fired up and serving and obeying Him. Come on. Getting your blood pumped, excited, motivated, and enthused for Him. Man, I used to get so enthused about the games, you know, and about sports. Man, my blood was pumping. Amen.
Yes.
We need to do the same thing for Him. We need to do even more for Him.
Yes.
Amen. Getting a passion that is getting stirred up,
yes,
on a daily basis.
Amen.
Amen. Nobody's going to stir you up. The Bible says stir yourself up. Because nobody's going to do it for you. You got to do it yourself.
Yes.
Amen. You got a lot of people out there that hate you. You got a lot of people out there that don't care for you. You got a lot of people out there that just don't care about you at all.
Mm.
So you need to stir yourself up.
I
don't want to be, I don't want to copy Him. I want to be an original,
yes,
and be like Christ and imitate,
yes,
God, imitate Jesus, you know?
Yes.
And I'm going to stir myself up. Stay hungry and,
yes,
thirsty for Him.
Yes.
You know, when you're full of Him, you got room for nothing else.
That's it.
You know, the world tries to get in, but there's no room for Him.
No room.
No room. There's no room in the end. Stay hungry and thirsty for Him.
Yes.
Not sometimes, but all the time. All the time. Always. Again, we're called to be available and passionate for Him. What is your passion? Hopefully, Him first. You know, if you're going to have a priority list, even at your job, wherever, we had a priority list in the military. For all the years I served, we had a priority list. But I always had God first. Amen. And then, whatever comes next, praise God. God gave His best. Jesus gave His best.
Mm-hmm.
We must give our best.
Yes.
We must be available. We must be passionate in serving Him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He calls us here to be servants.
Servants.
Amen. Not servants. The Bible says in Matthew that Jesus came to serve, not to be served.
Not to be served.
Amen. So, again, He's a great example.
Yes.
When you hear being available and being passionate, what comes to mind? Again, excited. Motivated, stir up.
Yes.
You gotta stir yourself up.
Yes, you do.
There's so much negative stuff out there right now. There's so many distractions out there right now.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta stir yourself up. Amen. We stir ourselves up and get motivated by so many other things.
Mm-hmm.
And when it comes to serving Him, we just don't. We gotta change that.
Mm-hmm.
Excited to be a Christian. Excited to be a believer. Excited to be a servant of God. Do the people you work with, do they know you're a Christian?
Mm-hmm.
Do the people you hang out with, do they know you're a Christian?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you had a spiritual birth.
Yeah.
They still see the same you, but inside, I had a spiritual birth.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm going to walk and talk and live,
mm-hmm,
my born again self.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'm gonna do these things because it's changed. And I'm going to talk different. I'm going to hang out with different people, and I'm going to do what He's called me to do.
Yeah.
Amen. And some people are just going to fall off.
Mm.
They're just going to go away and say, man, you've changed, man. We can't hang out with you no more.
Mm.
That's right. That's good. But God's going to bring all the right people around you.
Yes.
All the right people He wants around you. Excited because God loves me. Excited about Jesus. Excited about Bible study. Excited about assembling ourselves together.
Yeah.
Man, I can't wait to assemble ourselves together. I want to let you know, brother. The Lord wants me to tell you He's excited that He's encouraging you.
Mm-hmm.
And you're doing good. Amen. And building each other up instead of competing against each other.
Yeah.
Amen. Putting each other down. No, we got to lift each other up.
Yes.
Amen. Come on, man.
Amen.
Remember,
good
church, He paid a price He did not owe. And I owe a debt I cannot pay.
Mm-hmm.
So, Lord, I'm just going to be available to you. I'm going to be passionate in serving you. He's calling me to be a minister of reconciliation.
Yes.
Amen. He's also, the Bible says also in Ephesians, he's given us gifts. What are the gifts he's given us? The apostle, the prophet, the evangelist, pastor, and the teacher. A fivefold ministry. But also, he's called the rest of us to be ministers of reconciliation. He's called us to be ambassadors for Christ.
Yes.
Amen. You're his mouthpiece wherever you happen to go.
Yeah.
When you're around people, they either confess in positive things or negative things.
Yes.
What are you doing? Remember, he's with you all the time. He knows what you're saying, and he knows what you're doing.
Yeah.
Well, we try to be nice Christians when we come assemble ourselves together. But God knows. Amen. So we gotta stop being pretenders. Amen.
Yeah.
Be for real. Passionate believers talk it, show it passionately. They walk the walk and they talk the talk.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not ashamed to say, hey, I'm a Christian, I'm a believer. I'm a child of God. And you know what? If they accept me, fine. If they don't, fine. But I'm not going to change for them.
That's it.
Watch your words and watch your actions.
Mm-hmm.
The enemy, not only people watching, the enemy is watching.
Yeah.
Not only is he watching, he's listening.
Yeah.
Because you're going to open the door for him to come.
Mm-hmm.
If you start confessing all the negative things,
yes,
you're opening the door for him to come.
Mm-hmm.
So be careful. You know, instead of saying it, just hold and guard your words.
Yes.
Amen? Ooh, man.
Amen.
And speak faithful words.
Yeah.
Can't say it enough. Available and passionate believers, stay passionate for him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? Used to be passionate for the world. Now I am passionate and stay passionate for him. The choice is yours. It's your choice. Nobody's going to force you. Nobody's going to make you. You have to stir yourself up. And you got to be able to say, I'm going to make this change. I'm going to change. Why not get passionate? And why not be available for him? Serving him and his people passionately, daily. You know, I've got a couple of scriptures I like that I want you to write these down. And let's go to Colossians 3:23. One of my favorite scriptures. 3:23. And 24. Are you there?
Getting there. Okay.
And whosoever you do it heartily as unto what?
The Lord.
To the Lord, and not unto men, knowing that of the Lord ye shall receive a reward of inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So whatever you do, know. Ron, mark these down. Colossians 3:24, and you can go there for yourself and see. Lord, I'm doing, you know, when you're in front of people, you just can't hang out with Christian people.
That's it.
When you work, you hang out unbelievers out there also.
Yeah.
But you know what? He died for them too.
Yes, he did.
Amen. So you got to walk the walk and talk the talk. And you got to share and have love and compassion for these people too.
Mm-hmm.
And share the word of God with them. And let them know. When they say, man, you're so different. What happened to you? Say, I was born again.
Mm-hmm.
I accepted Christ in my life.
Yes.
Amen. He's the Lord of my life now. I'm serving him. And I'm passionate to serve him. And you can do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And now I'll go to Hebrews 16.
Yes.
It's just a few. There's so many, but you can... Hebrews 6, chapter 6, verse 2 says, for the Lord is not unrighteous to forget your work and labor of love, which ye have shown towards his name,
mm-hmm,
in that ye have ministered to the saints and do minister.
Amen.
So he don't forget what you do.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, I think it was last week that what I shared with you is that you're too blessed to be stressed.
That's it.
You're too blessed to be worried.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You're too blessed to be down on anything.
Yes.
Amen. And I think we sang our song that says, count your blessings.
Yes.
Not your worries. Not your cares. Count your blessings.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. I'm so blessed.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Don't forget to thank him for it.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I'm excited. I want to read you a story now. This story is about four people that were available and passionate in Mark chapter 2. Let's go there. Let's read that. I've got it written here from the New Living Translation, but I want to read it from the King James. Mark chapter 2 and verse 1 through 12. Are you there? Here we go. A man with the palsy is what? Healed. And again, he entered in Capernaum. After some days, and it was noisome, and he was in the house. And straightway many were gathered together in some, so much that there was no room to receive them. No, not so much as about the door. And he preached the word unto them.
Yes, he did.
And they come unto him, bringing one sick of the palsy, which was born of four. Verse 4. And the man could not come nigh unto him for the press. They uncovered the roof where he was, and when they had broken it up, they let down the bed wherein the sick of the palsy lay. And Jesus saw their faith, and he said unto the sick of the palsy, Son, thy sins be forgiven thee. But there were certain of the scribes sitting there and reasoning in their hearts. Why doth thou this man thus speak blasphemies? Who can forgive sins but God only? And immediately when Jesus perceived in his spirit that they so reasoned with themselves, he said unto them, Why reason ye these things in your hearts? Whether it is easier to say to the sick of his palsy, Thy sins be forgiven thee? Or to say, Arise and take up thy bed and walk. But that ye may know that the Son of Man hath power on earth to forgive sins.
Yes.
He has said to the sick of the palsy. And verse 11 says, I say unto thee, Arise and take up thy bed and go thy way unto thy house.
Yes.
And immediately.
Yeah.
And immediately. Immediately, it says, he rose, took up the bed, and went forth before them all, insomuch that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, We never saw it on this fashion. Amen? Immediately.
Yeah.
So we're talking about four men that were available and were passionate to say, you know, they weren't doing it for themselves.
Right.
They were doing it for somebody else.
Yeah.
You know, you're in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And there comes a time when you could be a blessing to somebody.
Yes.
Instead of putting them down. It's easy.
Right.
Everybody does that.
Yeah.
But be a blessing to somebody. He's called you so that you could be a blessing for somebody.
Yeah.
He says he blesses you to be a blessing. Amen. And there was no more room.
Right.
They couldn't even walk in. And they didn't send a note to Jesus. They couldn't go in. So I don't know whose house that was, but they went and they ripped the roof off. I don't know what the owner was, but they knew exactly where to rip the roof. And they lowered the bed right in front of Jesus. What did Jesus, did he get mad?
No.
He said he saw their faith.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? He saw their faith. So we need to practice this ourselves, you know. When we see somebody hurting and down, you know, we just don't go and show off and talk against them.
No.
We see the hurt. We see and speak to them and lift them up, you know. A kind word can lift somebody up.
Yeah.
Amen. Instead of putting them down. Say, God wants you to know he loves you.
Yes.
Amen. Or say what we're to say.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we hold our words and don't say anything, and we were supposed to.
Yeah.
God told you to speak to this person and say this person something, and we held it.
Mm-hmm.
But we're supposed to speak when we're supposed to. Amen.
Woo!
Hallelujah. In the Amplified, it says, "Stand up," it says, "and pick up your mat and go home." And the man immediately. Amen. he didn't say, well, I'm crippled, I can't do that.
Mm-mm.
No. He says immediately.
Yes.
Sometimes, you know, when you have a word from God and He tells you to do something, you say, well, I can't.
Mm.
You know, because we're still in the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
And He's talking the Spirit. Mm-hmm. And He says, immediately he jumped up, grabbed his mat, and walked out through the stunned onlookers.
Uh-huh.
Every part of him functioning normal.
Yes.
And they were all amazed and praised God passionately, exclaiming, we've never seen anything like this before. Well, you know what? When we kick Jesus out of schools, we kick him out of churches, we kick him out of everything else, you ain't never gonna see nothing like that.
That's it.
Amen. But you know, when we invite him to come, he's gonna come in.
Yes.
He says, I'm knocking. We need to let him in. So it's time that you accept that friend request from Jesus. Amen.
Yeah.
Some of you listening, this time that you say, it's time for you to say, Jesus, come into my life.
Yes.
Be my Lord and Savior. I accept your friend request. He wants to be your friend for life.
Yes.
Amen. So immediately, there was no doubt. The crippled man jumped up and did what Jesus told him to do. I'm sure he blessed the four men that was there. Four passionate believers and their mission. Get the paralyzed man to Jesus. These men knew Jesus could help. Their mission is to get their friend to Jesus.
Yes.
I mean, these guys are believers. They said, if we can get him to Jesus, he'll take care of him. And then we have faith. We can lead out these four passionate men daily, every day. Wouldn't settle for a no from Jesus. They wouldn't settle for Jesus sending one of his men or his disciples to come and pray for him.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't settle for that.
Mm-hmm.
What is your passion today? One thing that we must do is get saved, be available, serve him, obey him passionately, and go and spread the word of God. Amen? We can do it. Mm-hmm. But people are going to hold you back if you let them.
Yeah.
People are going to try to hold you back. Don't let him hold you back. Amen? If you don't know where you're going, you probably end up somewhere else. But God has a plan for you. Stay in tune with him. Have a relationship. And you'll end up at the right place every time. Now we call it GPS. You know, if you're tuned, you can take you exactly where you need to go.
Yeah.
And you know, Jesus had the GPS Bible forever. And that'll take you exactly where you need to be.
Yeah.
You need to be right. You need to be hooked up with him.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. It'll tell you exactly what you need to do. Amen.
Lord.
Come on now. Let me see what else you got, Carmen. My part is to be available to God for his purpose in our gifts and give him the glory.
Mm-hmm.
He's giving you these gifts. And you know what he says about your gifts? He says he won't take them back.
That's it.
He's giving you these gifts. So don't. He's not going to take them back. Use them and glorify him. Amen. Keep going. God has uniquely, unequally gifted you to help someone. Be available as God opens doors for you to do so. Isn't that awesome? Amen. He's gifted you to help someone. Not only once in a while, but daily. Be available as God opens doors for you to do so. Thank you, Lord, for opening doors. What is it you want me to do today, Lord? Talk to him. He's there for you. He's going to talk to you. Keep going. Awesome. Oh, I like this one. Be yourself. No matter what other people think, God made you the way you are for a reason. Besides, an original is always worth more than a copy. Be original, be yourself, and be available. Amen. We're always trying to copy somebody else.
Yeah.
And that's not what God calls you to be.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to know what you are or what God calls you to be is, talk to him.
Yeah.
He's going to tell you what he's called you to be. But you got to be the original he called you to be. He's the potter, we're the clay. and these babies, amen. So praise God. Be yourself and be available. Be the original. Don't try to copy somebody else. If you're going to copy anything, you copy, be imitate Christ.
Amen.
Amen. So praise God. Praise God, praise God, praise God. We're not going to finish this. This is just taking it slow. We're not going to hold you long. We need to know this.
Yeah.
About being available. We put it off too long. We need to make ourselves available. You know, we always want God, or we want Jesus to be available for us all the time. Amen. We go to knocking all the time. Morning, noon, evening, night, doesn't matter. We always seek Him, and we want Him to be there. And we want Him to listen, and we want Him to answer quick.
Yeah.
Well, He wants us to be available because we're His body. Who's He going to use in the earth? He's going to use His body. He's going to use us. So, you know, regardless of who told you what, God wants to use His people.
Yes,
God wants to use you. And you can point yourself, a key, right here. You, God wants to use you. I don't care. Forget about what people say. God wants to use you. If you can forgive your sins and forget your past, so can you. People might not, but you can. Amen. And God, Jesus will, and you must do the same thing. Forget about your past. He says, you're a new creature in Christ. The old is gone, the new is in. So people are still holding things against you. No, let it go.
Yeah.
I'm a new creature in Christ.
Amen.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Yes.
Stay passionate and filled with God's plan for my life.
Yeah.
Stay focused and enjoy where you're going, on the way to where you're going. Oh, excuse me. Enjoy where you are on the way to where you're going, and bloom where He plants you.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to be negative wherever God plants me. I'm just going to be a blooming flower for Him, and bloom and serve Him everywhere, anyway, and every way I can. And you can do the same thing. But you got to see yourself as a servant of God, as an imitator of God, and not a loser,
right?
Not a nobody. I'm going to be a servant of God, and I'm going to be available to Him, and I'm going to serve Him passionately. Amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Keep on coming. Be who God meant you to be, and you will be, and you will set the world on fire. So this is the way He sees you. We need to see ourselves the way He sees us. It says you can set the world on fire. You know, well, you know, you start comparing and competing with big-time people. I don't care how big or how small you serve. Just do it, be available, and do it passionately unto Him. He's going to bless you. Amen? He's going to bless you, and you're going to be a blessing. Keep going. And this is our text was right here. It says, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And whom shall go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me, Isaiah 6 and 8. Make yourself available to God. I can't say it enough. Make yourself available to God. You know, we punish ourselves too much, and people push us down, and we stay down.
Mm.
No. It says, you know what? It's time to dust yourself off, get up, and continue on your walk. Continue on your mission.
Mm-hmm.
Amen? The enemy's going to use all kinds of people to try to hold you down because people are jealous.
Mm-hmm.
God has a plan for everyone.
Yeah.
Jeremiah 29:11. Easy to read our version says this. I say this because I know the plans that I have for you. That I have for you. You can scratch that and put your name there.
Amen.
He has a plan for you.
Yes, He does.
Regardless of who's told you what.
Mm-hmm.
I have a plan for you, Jose. This message is from the Lord. I have good plans for you, Jose. I don't plan to hurt you. I plan to give you a hope and a good future.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm excited. Well, a few more scriptures and we're done. Proverbs 16:3 says in the Amplified, commit your works to the Lord, submit and trust them to Him, and your plans will succeed if you respond to His will and guidance.
Yes.
Amen. Submit yourself to Him, to His will and His guidance, In Proverbs 16:3, in the New King James says, commit your words to the Lord, and your thoughts will be established.
Yes.
Amen. So we'll stop there, and we'll continue next week on being available to God.
Amen.
And how can I serve Him? How can I do? How can I be available to Him? Amen. The Lord says, I have a plan for you. Man, this is awesome. So let's close it there. And Father, we just thank you for the opportunity to read your word, study your word, Lord, and thank you for being there for us, Lord. We want to be available to you, Father, and thank you that we're learning. We're learners and not failures. We're learners, Father God, and learning your word to study to show ourselves approved and mature in your word, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise God, praise God. Thank you, Lord. If you've never accepted Jesus, you know, you've been saying all this time, well, it's too late, He can't use me. It's a lie.
That's right.
He wants to use you. The first thing you need to do is receive Him, accept Him as your Lord and Savior. And all you have to do is just invite Him with your mouth, confess this and say this. It says, Lord Jesus, I've sinned against you. Mm-hmm. I repent. Come in my life and be my Lord and Savior. Mm-hmm. Amen. And you know what? He's going to come. He's going to come in because you're inviting Him and you're opening up, and He's going to come in and be your friend for life. Amen. And be your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you for this opportunity, Lord. And before we close, we're going to pray for all those people, Father God, that are going through whatever they're going through, COVID-19 or whatever else, whatever sickness. The Bible says that by Jesus Christ, we were healed.
Yes.
Amen. So, spirit of infirmity, spirit of sickness, we cancel your assignment against God's people. We command you to go in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you that by Jesus Christ, people are healed right now, Father God, within the reach of my voice, Father God.
Thank you.
Listening and watching, thank you. The healing belongs to you because you're a child of God. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Thank
praise
you,
God. I receive my healing. That's all you have to say. I receive my healing. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Praise God. It's time to give. You're watching and listening. You'd like to give your tithes and offerings? You can still do them. Just go to our website, nbcbigbid.com, and press that donate button.
Email.
If you mail it, NBC, P.O. Box 252, Marfa, Texas, 79843. God bless. God loves you, and we love you. God bless you. Amen. Praise God.